The elements of the fourth industrial revolution, or industry 4.0, have already entered our daily life. And the mining industry is not the exception. The technology is being implemented here with a fantastic pace, assisting the humans in hard continuous jobs and creating the new jobs opportunities. My name is Vladimir Sosoev. I work as a global product manager for the automation here at Epiroc. And together with my colleagues from Sims, we would like to demonstrate one step towards the higher efficiency. Now we are on the way to our test mine in Örebro County in Sweden, the place where we are testing our technology before put it in field and after all the lab tests are conducted. And to get there we are using the modern car that has all the existing features, and among others it has the latency assist function that turns me back if I get too close to the center of the road or too close to the side of the road. I'm wondering if this feature will be applicable in underground conditions as well. Please explain what we are doing here today.
Today we are going to test the driver assist function. And that is a function that fills the gap between telemote operation and autonomous operation. You know, as a telemote operator, it's difficult to drive fast because you're not in the machine. But with the loader assist functionality, we will use the gliders in the machine to prevent the operator from driving to the wall. Mm-hmm. And with this function, we can increase the drop speed of the telemote operations. So we will fill the gap between the telemote operator and autonomous operation. Using the driver assist function will increase the speed for the telemote loader. Because when we stop hitting the wall, we can drive faster.
Yes.
Of course, it depends on the condition of the road in the mine. But by using the driver assist function, there is no technical limitation to how high the speed could be. It could end up being the maximum speed of the loader.
Johan, you are the one who has developed the code.
Yeah, that's right.
Could you please explain in two words on how does the algorithm work?
Sure, it's rather simple. We have laser sensors on the machine that scan the surroundings, measure the distance to the walls, and then we use that information to calculate the path ahead of the machine that we can follow to avoid the walls.
Sounds great. May I try that?
Absolutely.
Yeah, now I'm driving to the right.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's just for the wall.
Yeah.
Can I switch on the second gear?
Yeah.
Okay, now it's faster.
And put it to the front and then try it to the right.
Quite aggressive.
Okay, let's try it.
Yeah, exactly.
Uh-huh. That's good. What will we do now?
Yeah, we will try this third scenario. We'll try to run into a dead end stop.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is it okay to run with a full speed?
Yeah, like, it's okay.
So I just full throttle till the end of the
route. End of the tunnel, yeah.
All right.
Approaching to the right turn.
Yes.
You see that now, yeah, now I'm going to
Okay, Jon, that was really impressive. So I really challenged the loader, but I didn't touch the wall once. Tell me, is that do we have any limitations on how we which machine and what that infrastructure the machine?
No, not whatsoever. It's completely independent of the communication infrastructure or machine size or type.
Oh, that sounds great. I think it's time to put it on the market. Thank you.
Excellent.